In 2017, some Redditors started to notice strange comments appearing under random posts. They were coming from an account with the username FujitaGaiken001. All the posts, with one exception, were repeating variations of the same sentence. I face serious problems of human rights at FujitaGaiken Thailand. Please help me. Some of those who spotted the comments thought that FujitaGaiken001 was a spam bot or a troll, but others thought that they were actually coming from a Japanese national who'd fallen victim to modern slavery in Thailand and was crying out for help. In today's episode of Reddit Unsolved, we're going to look at the troubling case of FujitaGaiken001. On the 6th of March, a Redditor named Kaziel stumbled across one of FujitaGaiken001's comments under a promoted post of an unrelated podcast, and made a thread discussing the post in the Reddit Bureau of Investigation subreddit. They quickly figured out that FujitaGaiken was a real company from Japan, which operates a factory in Thailand, and, as Kaziel pointed out, Thailand has a severe modern slavery problem, where human trafficking, debt bondage, and forced labour are all frighteningly common. The Thai fishing industry is especially rife with these disgusting abuses. But others are also affected, and even large foreign multinationals like Nestle have discovered human slavery in their supply chains. Although the Thai government has taken steps towards addressing the issue, as Amnesty International points out, since 2014 at least, many human rights activists have been fined or even forcibly disappeared, and the government has recently passed repressive legislation to ban human rights groups and NGOs which criticize the government. Also, if this article is correct, and I believe it is, escaped slaves are often returned to their captors or sold on by police and authorities. With all this in mind, Kaziel thought it was very likely that FujitaGaiken001 was indeed enslaved and being forced to work in inhumane conditions at the FujitaGaiken factory in Thailand. Looking at Google reviews today, we can see a list of one-star reviews calling out the company for poor working conditions and forced labour. On the surface, this would seem to prove that there are indeed human rights abuses occurring at FujitaGaiken. But if we look a little bit closer, we can see that the majority of these reviews were left 5 years ago, at about the same time that FujitaGaiken started posting. It's more than likely that these comments were left by Redditors who stumbled across FujitaGaiken001's posts and review bombed what they perceived to be the bad guys. I'd like to be completely honest here and point out that from what I've seen, there's no evidence whatsoever that there's anything shady about FujitaGaiken. By all accounts, they produce high-precision vibration test equipment. This video by one of their partners shows that the interior is modern and sleek, and all the workers shown were doing pretty precise and high-tech work. A look at the Japanese website shows that they hire inexperienced people, and the pay and benefits seem pretty good, and they also pay for travel and overseas boarding. Some people considered the possibility that FujitaGaiken001 was actually just a bot. There are some factors that point to this conclusion. They don't respond to any of the replies, even after some people posted instructions on how to contact Amnesty International. Finally, the randomness of the places they chose to post is worth mentioning. If someone were really going to appeal to help using this as their tool, why not focus on an appropriate subreddit? Although the randomness, gibberish, and lack of replies could also be explained by someone with limited English, like a Japanese national, opening Reddit and simply copy-pasting phrases through Google Translate into random front-page topics. And the fact that Google Translate is complete arse when translating Japanese to English would back this up. Having said that, one phrase translated into English does actually make sense. It is power harassment at Thailand. Google pointed me down a whole other rabbit hole here. Power harassment is a fairly broad category of workplace bullying that can range in severity from mild to extreme. The phrase originates from South Korea and Japan. Further evidence that FujitaGaiken001 is Japanese. Another account was then discovered that seemed to be the same user posting the exact same phrase. You help 001001001. And I'm just gonna say help from here on. There were two more Japanese language posts in this second account. The first, which was posted to Reddit on February 17th, 2017, translates to, "The story is long and incoherent, the voice is big and frustrating, so I was told to shut up." This appears to have been copy-posted from an anonymous Japanese message board called 2Channel. The original thread it was posted to seems to be discussing ADHD, how to get a diagnosis, and how to treat it. The other Japanese comment in FujitaGaiken's alt account also points to a 2Channel thread, this time a thread discussing victims of narcissistic personality disorder. Google Translate has again done a number on this one, so the meaning has been lost in translation. Also, 2Channel, like 4chan, is an anonymous message board, so it's hard to tell who's speaking and who's replying. So this again takes us back to that nebulous term, power harassment. With all this in mind, it seems more likely that this is a Japanese person who works at the Fujita Gaiken factory in Thailand and is experiencing workplace bullying from one or more colleagues and feels so trapped that their only course of action is to seek help and advice from anonymous Japanese forums and Reddit. Or Fujita Gaiken 001 is a Japanese person who is trolling us, either to simply waste our time, or possibly to attack and smear Fujita Gaiken over some personal vendetta. Whatever the case may be, Fujita Gaiken's posts have produced an effect. From the initial thread, we can see that multiple people contacted both Amnesty International and the factory, and they likely even contacted Fujita Gaiken's head office in Japan. And then there's all the people who did one or all of the above and never posted about it. We can assume that this must have happened by looking at the negative reviews that started appearing on Google after Fujita Gaiken started posting. If Fujita Gaiken was an actual modern slave or a bullied employee, then he has likely been tracked down by the company or Amnesty International and has either been saved or punished. If he was a troll or someone with a vendetta, then the company has been smeared and his objectives were achieved. Kind of makes you wonder about that video showing how great the Fujita Gaiken factory is when you consider it dropped just shortly after the Fujita Gaiken mystery resurfaced after someone made a post about it on the Internet Mystery subreddit. This could all very well be an attempt to combat negative publicity from Fujita Gaiken 001's posts for all we know. The only other thing I found under one of the comments in Help's post history is this random email address which points to the customer service line of a Swedish furniture store. I have no idea why this might be in here. If they were using someone else's phone, I guess maybe this was already in the clipboard and they accidentally pasted it, but the company doesn't seem to have any connection whatsoever to the Fujita Gaiken factory, so. But all this conjecture is just hiding the plain and simple fact that this is where the trail goes cold. There are no further clues in either Fujita Gaiken 001's posts or their alts, and without learning fluent Japanese, I can't pull any further context out of the two channel threads. So I'm handing this off to you. If you'd like to have a go at solving this one yourself, have at it. I'll put the pertinent links in the description. But for now, this one remains unsolved. Until next time.